The wean to serve interval is the period after weaning where sows are recovering from their lactation and preparing for their next estrus cycle. When removing the sows from the farrowing house, always prepare the passageways first so there are no distractions to the sows. This is also the time when the sows are mixed to form their stable groups. We must provide a wean to serve area that has enough space for sows to be able to move away from fighting or aggressive sows. So we want a well bedded area to provide a good non-slip surface. This area should be well lit and ideally have 16 hours of light, but at least 12 hours. The temperature of the house should also be comfortable for the sows to live in. Clean water must always be available, and for sow drinkers, a flow rate of 2 litres per minute is recommended by the welfare code. We want sows to eat well at this time, so they should be given food on an ad lib basis or at least fed to appetite. Ideally, a lactation diet or a special wean to serve diet is fed to them at this time. It is really important that sows are introduced to the boar at weaning, as this helps to kickstart the countdown to their estrus cycle. This will help any sow that has lost body condition while suckling her litter, and is especially important for weaned parity 1 sows. The boar contact can either be from an adjacent pen to provide nose-to-nose contact, or the boar can be introduced to the pen for about 20 minutes each day. It is important that the boar you use has good libido and is happy to stand and chat to the sows, but is not overly aggressive towards them. Keep checking your sows daily for signs of an early return to heat. And finally, it is imperative that you remove the boar for at least 24 hours before you start your heat detection. This means that if you're weaning on Thursday, the boar should be removed by Sunday morning at the latest.